Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Fans POV here in Sandusky, Ohio, at the Kalahari Resort and Convention Center for ColossalCon 2015. Hey, everyone, I'm your host, Chrissy Lawler, and with me are the usual crew of our little ragtag bunch. Hi, Chris.
Sup.
And always Ernie.
Hi.
So enthusiastic, aren't we? Well, like I said, we're here at ColossalCon. We've heard a lot about it, mostly from a lot of pictures and videos by you guys, the fans, and some other videographers and photographers. So we knew we had to come. ColossalCon is, like we said, in the middle of Ohio at a Kalahari Resort and Convention Center, which has the convention center, the hotel, and then which has a indoor water park, outdoor pool, a mini zoo where you can feed animals, and play with some of the baby animals like tigers and lions, which we will get to later. It's a 4-day con, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, with pre-reg pickup on Wednesday evening, which is when we arrived Wednesday, because, you know, we got to do the whole pre-reg pickup, and you got to scout out the location. So, Chris, Ernie, expectations come to this convention.
I didn't have a lot of expectations on the convention itself. Not that I thought it was going to be a dumb convention or anything like that. All I saw was the music videos and the photographs, and it was all within the resort. So with the lions and everything. So I had no idea what to expect from the convention itself. But my expectations were met for what I was expecting.
Ernie,
My expectations here were a lot of water themed or water tailored cosplays, because since we do have the water park here, and after seeing all the music videos and the photos and all that, I was expecting a lot of either summertime, vacation time type of cosplays. But the actual, as Chris said, I agree with you, it's the actual convention itself, there was no I didn't really know what to expect, because everything I see was out here. That's what my expectations were. So
no, that's same here. There's most of the coverage that I've seen online is all outside the resort, the water park, the animals. Not a lot is shown of the convention itself. My expectations, though, were a little higher for the convention. I did expect a lot bigger, but from what it seems, it's almost like with a couple of other conventions we've gone to, the venue is the focal point, not the convention. So everyone is outside taking pictures and video in their cosplays with the really pretty locations of the water park, the pools, and the animal part, little mini zoo. So what was everyone's first expectations when we arrived? Like I said, we arrived Wednesday evening.
To quote Will Smith from MIB, damn.
Ernie?
They have laser tag here. That's all you need. They have laser tag.
Yes, they have an arcade, a really big arcade with laser tag, a glow-in-the-dark mini golf, mini bowling. It's
they have a laser game that you can play.
Too? I thought it was just laser tag.
Yeah, no, they have a lot of things. And I think they might be starting to kick people out of the pool area. What time is it? It's 5:22. Never mind.
It closed at 6.
It closed at 6, yeah. Alrighty. So, yeah. The resort is gorgeous. The water park and the pool area and the arcade are what we were in awe. The convention center area it's small, but it's not too confusing, and actually the hallways are pretty wide, so it's not like the narrow hallways of most hotels that we've been to. So it's nice. The hotel is nice, is gorgeous. The convention center is nice. The resort part is amazing. And let's just say Wednesday night, we didn't even pick our badges up yet, and we already planned for coming back next year. We didn't do panels. We were having too much fun everywhere else. I think from the program looked like pretty much the standard on panels.
It looked a lot more fan panels than industry type panels. Yeah. You'll see a lot more the fans doing stuff than we'll say Funimation does an industry panel, or Crunchyroll does an industry one. So there's not really going to be many industry panels here. It's everything fan.
I didn't really, and I think when we took the walk through the deals room, I didn't see any industry booths. I think this is just totally geared towards just fan.
Yeah.
It's nothing really towards the industry. Yeah, you don't do panels anyway.
And when I do, though, they're more fun when they're a fan panel than when they're an industry panel.
Main events, like we said, we were spending most of our time outside and filming the cosplayers in the resort area, so we really didn't get to the main events. We did want to try the masquerade, but we ended up, a lot of times we've noticed when cons start doing stuff on like Wednesday and Thursday, the whole weekend gets thrown off. Okay. So by Saturday, you're exhausted. So we actually went back to, we didn't stay here. We stayed at the hotel down the road. We were exhausted. I think we went back to our rooms. What was it, 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock?
Yeah, I think around there.
So unfortunately, we're sorry, Colossal. We didn't get a lot to do with the panels and the main events and the masquerade. We're sorry.
It's tough because it's like a lot of the stuff that we wanted to do was outside, and that sun beating down takes a lot out of you. Well, especially you, but you
well,
know, yeah. So, but it's like, it's not like the panels are bad. It's just like the main focal point was everything out here in the water parks. And but still, you know, what I heard, the masquerade was great. Photo shoots were awesome.
I heard cosplays, the formal ball was great.
Formal ball, that I really wanted to go to, but I had no formal actual wear. So, I mean, you know, honestly, next year we'll be more panel eccentric and we'll try to do less of the cosplay music video.
Especially if we get John to come here. He's a pan. He's panels. Then I heard, I was really kind of interested in, they had a orchestra.
Oh yeah, the Symphonic Anime Orchestra.
So
yes,
that's
good.
Pretty cool. We saw them practicing on Thursday. That was pretty cool. I guess then we'll go to the Dealer's Room and Artist Alley. Chris, what'd you think of the Dealer's Room and Artist Alley?
At first, I thought they were really small for what I was expecting for ColossalCon as a convention, because, you know, the attendance, I figured, was a lot. So I was expecting something along the size of KatsuCon. It wasn't that, but they do this crazy thing on Sunday where people come in and sell their stuff, and it's called the flea market. That was nuts. So, I mean, I get why the Dealer's Room wasn't as large, and because you know when you have Sunday where you can get all these deals from other people who just want to get rid of stuff that they don't want anymore, you know, you're gonna buy from that person and you're gonna buy from the Dealer's Room, especially if you've been to ColossalCon and you know the flea market is happening on Sunday. You know, I didn't know the flea market was gonna happen on Sunday, but definitely a lot of cool stuff was in the flea market when I browsed through it.
What about the Artist Alley?
Artist Alley was also pretty small, but I mean, a lot of the stuff that you would find in the Artist Alley, you could also find in the flea market as well. But the Artist Alley had a lot of cool stuff, like the bathing suit booth.
Yeah. Ernie, what'd you think?
I agree with Chris. I think it was, they were both, Dealer's Room and Artist Alley were kind of small for a convention that's this size, but I think we talked about it on the car ride back home, I think on either Friday night or Thursday night, where the reason why it's so small is that because not everybody that's at ColossalCon is for ColossalCon. So, you know what I'm saying? Like, they're here for the venue, as we're saying before. So it's like, you know, and I think that sort of the convention understands that, and they try to cater to as much as they can to the people who actually buy a badge and who go in there. So that's why I think it's like kind of small, but it's kind of cool that it's small like that, because it's a lot of mom and pop shops, it's a lot of people who need the money and the exposure and all that stuff. So I like it. It's like a lot of fan oriented stuff, but I would love to see the flea market. I wish I knew about that more. So
yeah, we didn't really know about the flea market. Chris found it while he was with a couple of friends. We were, you know, doing last-minute filming and last-minute hangouts with a couple of other photographers and friends that we know. But I think the flea market is a very cool idea, because a lot of times people will buy a lot of stuff over the years, and then when it gets later on, they either don't need it anymore, don't want it anymore, or they have duplicates of stuff. Like, had I known, I'm bringing some of my manga that I don't want anymore. I can bring it next year. I've been trying to get rid of it, and nobody wants it. So next year, there we go. Usually I like when the Artist Alley is bigger, but I do like a little Artist Alley, because usually you'll get a lot of different stuff. So everything's different. My only thing is everybody, a lot of the artists will gear towards what's popular now rather than what's nostalgia stuff. Like, I like the older stuff. Like, one of the vendors I found of Ultron art, I'm like, you don't find that anymore. Now it's all going to be right now. It's going to be free and all that kind of stuff, the popular stuff right now. But the dealer's room had the same stuff that he normally does. Not that that's bad. It's just not my cup of tea.
Well, if you notice, we have a backdrop change. We, there was chances of rain and storm, so they basically evacuated the pool area, and man, we came inside, and now we're at our hotel, all comfy, cozy, ready to just chill. All right, so we were going on to cosplayers. What did you guys think of the actual cosplayers at this convention?
They were really good. I liked them.
Okay. Ernie?
They were very, very creative because a lot of... They wanted to utilize the thing, the water park as much as they can. So anything that they had, any cosplay that they were a specialty in, they basically made it water-themed or vacation-themed and all that great stuff. So, yay. But they were good. I liked them.
No, yeah, I agree. They were definitely very creative with some of them, like... Because you have to make if you're going to make them either a bathing suit or like a vacation-esque outfit, you still have to make sure that everyone knows who it is. You got to make sure that the colors, any kind of patterns, hair, just so that everyone knows who it is. Unless, you know, the show actually has bathing suits in it. Yeah. Otherwise, then they know who it is. Free, I think a couple of Sailor Scouts, because there have been some Sailor Moon episodes with them wearing bathing suits. But yeah, I think I really liked, they were definitely creative. I think it was just something different from what we're normally used to going to other cons. Did you guys see any particular trends besides the bathing suit and vacation theme?
No, not at all.
No, I didn't see any other than just the water theme. That was pretty much it. Just, that's it.
Yeah, I agree. Definitely, that was pretty much what... the only thing theme I've seen. I haven't seen any past one or two cons. I haven't really seen a cosplay, the main cosplay, the show that's the biggest thing right now. I think the last one was Homestuck, and they've kind of calmed down a little bit, but nothing has really risen up to completely take over. Like, I think we were saying Free kind of is there. Okay. I don't know the area. Oh, that's one of those ones web. I'll go figure it out later. Okay, sorry. Free's been a big thing lately, and a lot of the sports animes have been big, but nothing to the point where it completely takes over.
Yeah, like League of Legends was a little bit like that, and Borderlands, but Attack on Titan. But no, there's nothing really overly taken over, so.
Yeah, Attack on Titan was pretty big for a while, but it was never to the point where it took over most of the con. Yeah. Okay, so do you guys have a favorite cosplay?
That one guy, you guys saw him. He was definitely a warrior of chaos, and the only reason I knew this was because I screamed out blood for the blood god, and he responded with skulls for the skull throne. So he was awesome.
Yes, now I figured as much that was yours.
That's a tough one. Favorite one of the weekend. I'll go with Rufio. That's something you don't see often, but people, like, when you see it, people are like, Rufio! Oh! Like, all that stuff. So, I have to go with Rufio. It was a lot of fun filming with him. Well, it's always the same.
No, I'm not sure if you ever saw him. That's
no, I haven't seen that one. Unless I have, and then it's just like, all right, then...
I think there's always one every once in a while at a con, Rufio, and it's cool because it's something everybody likes.
It's something everybody likes and it's nostalgic.
Yeah, I don't think I have a favorite. Nothing really screamed out at me like, oh my god, I have to go take that one's picture, or oh my god, that is so cool. I did have a moment though where I think I made a cosplayer's day. We had split up for a few minutes to wander around looking for cosplayers to film, and I walked past a cosplay that I thought I recognized, and I went up to her. I'm like, I'm sorry, but I just got to ask, are you Crystal from the Inhumans for Marvel? And I think she was like, oh, yes, that's who I am. I'm like, oh, she's like, thank you so much. And I'm like, I figured I recognized you. I just had to double check. And I think she was very happy that somebody actually recognized her, because that character is not really huge unless you're big into the old Avengers and the Inhumans, because at one point she's married to another Avenger. She's married to Quicksilver.
Yeah. And the movie's not coming out until 2020, so.
Yeah. I just know the character because I liked Quicksilver a while as a kid. But yeah, I didn't really have a favorite. There were a couple that I'm like, oh, that caught my eye, but nothing ridiculous. Before we go on to a little bit the last couple things before the end of the show, I want to talk a little bit about the area and the Kalahari itself. Like we said earlier, Kalahari has a water park. It has a little, like, almost like petting, not a petting zoo, but it's a little zoo where you can feed some of the animals. Yeah, it's
like an animal reserve more.
You can feed the animals. There's the parakeet room that Chris had fun in. I think we all had fun in. Everybody had fun in that room. And then you could do a camel and horse ride. Then you
Chris
could.
Enjoyed that.
The horse is next year.
And then they had like a mini touch tank with a stingray.
They're shy here in Ohio. You go into New York, Boston, anywhere, those stingrays are like, rub me, please. And they come right up to you. These guys, you put your fingers in the tank, they're like, whoom. I was like, really? These guys are shy.
I would definitely say, even if you're not going to be doing a lot of cosplay and video pictures in there, it's still a lot of fun to go in, especially the parakeet room.
Yeah, it's only a couple bucks to go in, so it's not that much.
By parakeets, it's fun.
Yeah. I think we put in election money because we did the feeding with the we each got a bucket to feed the animals. The parakeet room was like $2. It was nothing. It was they were funny.
The zebras were a bit.
There was a couple of the animals that were close.
Like, I'm not walking all the way over there for that apple. You put another apple in there, and I was like, no, you go get that apple.
And then there was this one little, what was it?
Antelopes or something like that.
Yeah, that were just fighting for food. And it's just
nasty.
Like, oh. Yeah, that's
yeah,
a, okay.
They were getting nasty with each other.
It's like,
he
oh my.
Got attacked by baby goats, though.
Yeah, that was
because he had a bucket.
I had a bucket, and they just came all over.
Oh, you've got food.
Yeah. And I think, like, a good, like, all but two of them were over by you.
Over by
me,
I know.
Like we said, we definitely recommend doing that. If you gonna come for the weekend, come for like at least one extra day so you can do this. You can go over to the animals, you can do the water park if you don't want to do them in costume. There's plenty of places to eat in the area. It's just up the road from, I think, Applebee's, Olive Garden. There's a super Walmart. There's a Sonic.
If you go from the Kalahari north or south on there, I'm not sure, but it is north from the Kalahari. So it's just on the other side of the highway. You just keep going down. There's a whole bunch of places to eat and a whole bunch of just places in general, stores. It's a city area.
Yeah. There's at least, we counted, from the Kalahari to our hotel, the Maui, there is 9 hotels.
And it's about a minute drive, two.
Maybe 2 minute drive. Not walking distance for us, but it was not much of a drive. There's plenty of things to do around here. The places are very simple. We went to, what was it called, Pops? Pops. It was. It's a toy and comic book shop. Mm-hmm. Oh my God! The nostalgia that ran amok. But definitely, this is definitely worth an extra day or two to enjoy the area and to relax and to have fun with the resorts and the parks and restaurants. The restaurants in the hotel in the Kalahari are not ridiculously expensive, and the food is good, and it's not like anything out of the ordinary. Chicken, fish, beef, nothing ridiculous. Like, I can't pronounce half of those words. And
if you can't pronounce it, you shouldn't eat it. No, but it's good. It's the food, the buffet. That buffet.
Chris got almost sick from the buffet.
I have 4 plates.
He was a pig.
And then I couldn't move. He couldn't get. I just had to lay down for a while. That's
it. A while. He couldn't DDR. But yeah, it's definitely. He couldn't adult. This is definitely, like, we've always said it with Dragon Con, that's a vacation. This is something you make a vacation into. Because of the fact that it's in the middle of nowhere, but no, it's not in the middle of nowhere.
There's stuff to do. There's a lot of things to do, as opposed to when you go to Atlanta for Dragon Con, you gotta find stuff to do. Like, yeah, there's the aquarium, the Children's Museum, the World of Coke and all, but that's like, that's an extra 100 if you pay for all of those. Yeah. Here, it's like maybe an extra 50 to do the water park. That's for a couple of hours.
And that's not if you stay there a lot of the time. If you stay at the Kalahari, the badges for the park are included.
Yeah, and then Cedar Point Amusement Park is not that far away. It's about 20 minutes north. So, and that takes two. That takes two whole days to do, apparently, because of all the lines. So, yeah.
Depending on the day. Hopefully we'll get lucky.
There's one other thing I forgot to mention. That is they have like a wildlife thing, like with the animals, but they also have baby tigers, baby lions, baby marsupials.
I had to sniff my hand to sniff.
You can have, what goes with the hotel is you can do a half an hour session with one or two of the animals and just interact with them, pet them, feed them.
Snuggle them, mush them, kiss them, play with them, kidnap feed them, kid them.
We don't recommend the kidnapping.
There's one in my room right now.
No, there isn't. We couldn't do it this year.
Next year we'll take him back to our room.
What it is when they do the half an hour session, they actually, if you are staying at the hotel, they come to your room with the animal. If not, they'll find your room. If not, you can't afford to do that. You can get your picture taken with them. It costs us what? With the three of us, it costs us $56.
I don't remember.
Yeah. Well, we owe you money.
There was a lion.
We ended up with the lion cub. We took a picture with it, and we were able to pet it. And Chris was very upset.
His picture is awesome.
I
scared Chrissy.
I like mine. I took a picture with the tarantula. Loved it. I actually have the picture, so...
Yeah, so you'll have to see the pictures of us. But that's a lot of fun. That it is on the expensive side, but I say if you plan on going to Colossicon next year, save up. It'll be worth it. All right. Lowlights, likes and dislikes, Chris, and highlights of the con. Chris?
I mean, one of the highlights was that I walked right in, but the lion was after the con when we saw the lion, but that definitely would have been the highlight for me. Camel ride was kind of fun, too. I mean, everything. I had a blast. Get back to me.
All right, what are we doing? Both low?
Highlight and the low light.
Okay, well, the low light, this kind of happened after the con, waiting 40 minutes for that one tube ride. It was at the water park. It was fun. It was a fun time, but it was not worth the 40 minutes. I think we dried off as we were going up the stairs.
We got
dry by the time we went up there. That's definitely a low light.
Well, one of the reasons was we went to the water park. It was the pools outside were closed because it had been raining, so I think pretty much everybody was inside rather than out, both.
Yeah, that...
It was the... they only had one side of that. There's two sides to that, them to load so that they can constantly be loading people.
And also, we did not realize, but schools are out now.
Yeah, schools are out here in Ohio. That's a low light there, but then the highlight was riding the zip line. That was a good time. That goes around the outer part of the Kalahari, and it was a fun time. It was a little nerve-wracking at first. When I got up there, I was like, all right, give me a second. And not because I was scared or anxious, it's because I was winded. Those stairs are no joke. Those stairs are no joke going up there. And then, but as I waited, I got more anxious. I was like, let's do it. So went across on there. It was fun. You got to see like the whole park. I don't know if anybody said hi to me while I was writing it, but I said Red Robin, but exactly, no one said that. But yeah, that was a highlight for me.
I really didn't have any lowlights. It was a fun time, nothing really bad. The only thing that bad happened, I recommend sunscreen, lots and lots of sunscreen. Burnt.
You know what?
I'm not going to get into this again because you guys, I hate you and your ethnic skins. So we're not going to get into this because he's Italian. He don't burn, apparently. And I'm Irish. I'm Irish. The
Irish
sun
too.
Hates me. No. I've got probably got more Irish than you do.
I'm more Irish than Italian. Ha.
Go away. So I definitely, that was probably the low light for me, was because for 2 days I was in pain. I couldn't wear straps on.
I was really hurt.
It's finally
in pain for most of this week.
Well, that's because you did something stupid.
That wasn't my fault.
That's
yes,
your
he
low
fell.
Light.
No, 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 you know what? No, what?
We had no control over that.
No, he didn't. He fell off his raft in one of the slides.
Bullshit,
yes, I know, but I just landed on my butt. So yeah, I definitely recommend sunscreen because it was very sun. Like, even though it wasn't ridiculously sunny, a lot of the time we were near the water, so the reflection off the water was probably where half the burn came from.
It was definitely beating down. The sun definitely beat down.
So I recommend that. That was probably my low light, was getting burned, because I was in pain for a while. Like, my forehead hurt for a couple days. My back still kind of hurts, but not as bad as it did. Highlights.
Laser tag.
Laser tag was fun.
That's my highlight. Laser tag.
Yes, the arcade at the Kalahari has laser tag. I really don't have a highlight, though. I had fun the whole weekend, but nothing that stood out. It was nice seeing people. There was a couple of people I didn't expect to see that we saw, and we were like, oh, cool, we got to see you and say hi. Got to hang out with a few of our friends, especially the out-of-stater ones.
What up to Okai-Con? Yo.
You, Okai-Con. Yeah, I think that was about it. So I guess that leads us to ratings on a scale of 1 to 10. 1 being horrible, 10 being awesome. And why, Chris?
Well, I give it a 9.8.
That's almost Dragon Con number.
We didn't get the tigers in the room, so that's the only reason why we're missing the point two.
That point two.
Oh, I would expect that to drop at like 2, not point two.
Yeah, point two, because we still got to pet the lion.
Okay.
We just didn't have them in the room so that the possibility of me taking one home was there.
We don't recommend it.
I know how to take care of them.
That doesn't matter.
Lots of meat, and you just mush them a lot.
Yeah,
you know, you cuddle them. You let them know that you're mommy.
All right, come on, seriously.
9.8.
Okay.
Because we didn't get the that's the only reason. The rest of it, I had a blast. The cosplays were awesome. I had a fun time. The flea market was a cool idea. Overall, it was definitely a very awesome con. It wasn't huge, but it doesn't have to be huge to be an awesome con. It's what the people and the surrounding area can really make the con.
Ernie? I'm gonna go with an 8. I don't want to go too high with. I had some like pretty big expectations for it, but it's not like I didn't want to go too high with my rating because some of them weren't fulfilled. I think that, like, you know, they organized it really, really well. I think that the convention itself understands what their actual role is. People are here for the venue, and as Chris said, it was the people and the surrounding that make the convention, and they know how to handle registration as well. That was the easy part there. They know what they were doing in terms of that. And it was just like, and it was is really well organized. I think that we all had a blast at it. You know, and the attendees had fun as well. Both the people that wanted to go to the water park and actually go to the convention themselves. You know, there's some problems here or there. You know, it is getting, I think some people are saying it is getting a little bit too crowded, but I really don't see the crowds. Like, it's packed, but it's not, like, to the point of, like, New York Comic Con, where you're literally shoulder to shoulder, back to back.
Or Dragon Con.
Yeah, it's not, I don't think it's,
Otakon.
Or Otakon, yeah. So it's not, like, back to back packed, but it is, there are a lot of people here during that weekend. So I would give it an 8.
I guess I'd have to give it a 9. It wasn't the best it could possibly be, but I think that's because we weren't aware of all of the options of what we could do, what was available to us. Like, we didn't know about that. We didn't know about what was in the arcade. We didn't know what options there were at the con. Like, we didn't find out about the flea market until Sunday. Chris actually went in. We didn't know about it until after it had already closed. So I think next year might be higher because of the fact that now we know what our options are and we can plan and prepare for it. So I'm looking forward to next year, Colossal. That was a great job. And I guess the stupid question that we pretty much have already answered, are we coming back next year, guys?
We have a room booked.
We already got a two-room suite. We're coming back.
So that's
Even if we didn't want to go to the con, we have the room for that weekend, so we kind of have to come now.
Yeah, we have to come back here.
And we are dragging like at least 10 of our friends.
At least we know one of our friends is coming, so.
I know at least.
We're dragging 10 of our friends, but I'm dragging back a tiger.
Yeah, that I know.
Oh, I'm sorry. The overall rating is an 8.9. Repeating. So almost, it was practically a 9. So it was a really good score. Like we said, classically, you guys were pretty, really good. You were organized. You weren't ridiculously huge, but you knew that a lot of the people were here for the venue, so you didn't oversize the con and then make it, it's almost a waste if you make it too big. But you guys did a good job. We like some of the ideas that you guys have, and we're looking forward to coming back next year. If you would like to give us any of your comments, ratings, please leave a comment down below. If you want to see any of our other videos, either about Colossal or other conventions, please subscribe to our YouTube page. You can also find us on Facebook, The Fans POV. We are on Twitter, The Fans POV. Instagram, Tumblr. We are on a few other social media websites, but we are going to be cutting back access on them. Activity on them. The pages will still be there, like I think DeviantArt and Vinyl, but we're not really going to be active on them anymore. And the next time you will see The Fans POV will be
Anime Next.
I know, I was trying to remember the dates. June 12th through the 14th for Anime Next in Somerset, New Jersey. Ricardo will be there, and I think Ernie's going to be there for a day or two. And then I will be vlogging at Eternal Con on June 13th at in Garden City, Long Island, New York. So, which is pretty much the weekend after Colossal Con.
You had to China for
me. I'm not going to go see China. I'm going to see the Power Rangers. And that's us. That's it from Colossal Con. And we will see you guys all later. Bye.
Bye.
We go hide away in daylight. We go undercover, wait up the sun. Got a secret side in plain sight. Where the streets are empty, that's where we run.